Hey guys, Phantom Stories here. So just when I thought I was having a crappy night, something good happened. I thought I only had 3 packs of smokes left, but I actually found another pack of smokes when I was cleaning. So it was actually underneath my pantry stuff. So I don't have to go out now until Thursday. So that's good to get more smokes. Because now I have four packs, so that should last at least till Thursday or Friday. So that's good. At least, but I was just like, oh, all this time I wasted trying to make recipes that didn't work for me kind of gets me off a little bit, but then something good came. It's not too bad, so I'm kind of glad about that, because now I don't have to go out until Thursday, and like my ribs are actually a lot better now compared to before, because I've been taking Advil, so I think that's been helping a lot. And I'm actually shocked that I'm still awake, because it's like almost 5, and I've just been cleaning ever since. I even cleaned down the spice rack and cleared it off, so I did that. I also cleaned down the table, and now I'm cleaning the floor, and then later, if I don't fall asleep, I'm going to do the other half, the kitchen. So basically, I just did everything in quarters, just because it's easier on me. So I was like, well, since I was really, really disappointed, and then I was really happy. I'm like, I better do a quick update. So I just made the garlic fries, so that's good. And I'm also going to have some tofu soup, because I found my miso tofu soup that I made not too long ago. So that's good. So I might go to the corner store tomorrow, we'll see. I was thinking of going to No Frills, but I don't know if I really want to, because I really want to do laundry. And the corner store is like on the way to Sunrise Market, is on the way to where I pick up my family's kid. Not my kid, just family kid. So I might do that, but because I like having chips, they might be a little pricey, so I don't know yet. So I did have to get cat food too. But yeah, it's just, I don't know, crazy how expensive everything is right now. But at least now I don't have to really go out till like Thursday or Friday, or I don't have to go downtown. That's what I mean by going out. So by bus, it's like far, it's like 45 minutes. And if I clean more tonight, I might find another piece of salt, if I'm lucky. So I always have a knife that I just have to clean. That's what I use butter knives for. I have one knife that I use to scrape the floors when I can't get something off. So I've got that off now. So yeah, now I don't have to go anywhere. Oh, there's actually a dollar store on the way, so I might check out that dollar store, because they might have some really good chips there. So, but I'm not going to bother trying to make my own. It's just too difficult, and I wasted like 2 hours already just trying to make my own chips. So, yeah, I'll do that tomorrow. It might be a little cheaper because that's just on 33rd on Main and it's on the way to where I walk. But I really have to do laundry, so that's what I'm doing tomorrow. I also made some lentils that were in a can, so I'm gonna use that for my bread. And I still have some blueberries, so I'm gonna try to make some overnight oats with that. I have so much vegan milk still because I keep saying I'm gonna bake and I never get around to it. But so much guck. That's why I keep reminding people, if you guys can donate money, it does really help me and my cats. Or even gift cards, but you don't have to. It's just because right now everything's just so expensive. I'm trying to get myself out of debt. It's really hard. And I think that's another reason why I've been sleeping so much, is because I've been stressed out with not just cleaning and catching up on everything, but my ribs and trying to make ends meet. It's very stressful when you don't really have an income, but I am thankful for being on disability because, like I said, we get a free bus pass, so that really helps. And medication is paid for. I'm not quite sure about pension, like what you get on pension and stuff like that for older people. So I have to eventually look into that. But I still have to go get my pool pass renewed. So I might do that on Thursday. I might go downtown. I mean, I might go to the welfare office first to get my pool pass renewed because I know the sauna would really help with my ribs and my back, even though it puts me to sleep. But now that it's open again, I could go there. And I only spend like 10 minutes in the hot tub and then like 5 minutes in the cold water and then like 10 minutes in the sauna. And then I head home. But I'm so tired because I hate the heat, my body. And I even have a cold cloth on me, but that's why when people are like, "Oh, do you want to go to the pool together?" I'm like, "No." Because literally, I only spend maybe 10 minutes there, so it's 10, 20 minutes there, so it's not long. And I do walk, sometimes walk there, because it's not that far to the Liquor Center. But on the way home, I don't walk. I just take the bus. But also, my friend works there, so it'd be nice to go visit her when she's working as well. I use the sauna, but the sauna feels like really good. So yeah, this whole, even the spices I clean down too. So it's not just because they get dirty too, the bottles. So yeah, I did the floor sweep and wet. Then I just did the spice rack. Sorry, my phone's always in the spice rack. I cleared that off. And then I moved the spices, so then when I put them back, I cleaned the bottle. And I cleaned the big table, the big black table, and I did the dish rack. So I've been doing a lot of cleaning because I'm like, I've been cooking, but I have nothing to show for it. But at least I got something to show for the cleaning. But I'm still awake. I think it's too because I slept so much, and like I said, I did take the Adderall, so that helps a lot. Oh, and now I'm all caught up on Julia Faye's YouTube channel, so I started that from the beginning to the end. And I'm watching some of her videos again, just because for some reason that helps me sleep. Puts me to sleep. But I started watching, because, and I've been talking about Life with Cindy a lot, but now I'm watching her videos from the very beginning to the end, so now I get more of a thing. And then since I'm vlogging a lot, that's why I watch other vloggers to see what they do. Kind of like similar thing. So yeah, if you guys need a cleaning tool, I have the same butter knife that I use, and then I have a toothbrush as well for the corners like of the fridge and like, the sink to do. Then I have the bottle cleaner, and then I have whatever this thing's called. So I have those there. Eventually I do want to get some organizers from Dollarama, but they're just too expensive to like organize my shelves a little more. Like my spice rack, I don't even know where I got the spice rack, but I know I got it for free. But it's really disappointing that my cornstarch is out now, because my Twix bars, I need cornstarch. But I think if I use the potato starch, it should probably do the same thing, because you don't need that much. It's like one for a cup. And let's see, so I have a tub thing like this. So yeah, potato starch. So I'm pretty sure that should be like somewhere to, yeah, because it does say for baking. So perfect for gluten-free baking. So I think I'm going to use this since I'm out of the cornstarch. And then like I want to get like tubs like this I got from the dollar store, just to like put my things in. And then, like, I have over-the-counter things that I want to get. So, yeah, I have so many chia seeds, but I never use them, because I don't really eat salad anymore. And then, like, sauces that I got for free or from the dollar store I put in here. Still haven't gotten around to using them. Oh, I forgot I have a fajita seasoning and a burrito. But I don't really like burritos and all that. And I have hemp seeds. But I forgot what I was going to say. Oh yeah, I was going to try to get some wraps. To start doing wraps and stuff again, but at Dollarama, it was $3.99 for a small little thing like that. And I'm like, no. So that's why I don't have burritos and wraps and all that, because it's just too expensive. I know people are like, well, it's only $5. I'm like, yeah, $5 is $5. $5 I could use towards cat food or pop or chips. So, yeah, like, I keep seeing my pop and my chips only 99 cents, usually. So, it's not a lot. And I have been cutting down a lot, so. That's why I try juice next. But I'm just like, yeah, $5.99 is not a lot. But when all you have is $5.99, or all you have, like, right now, all I have is almost $15. That's all I have, so I have to be, like, very careful of how I spend it. Although I might, like, take in the pop bottles on Thursday or Friday, too. So, we'll see. I'm thinking of getting up earlier, but I'm still debating, like, if I want to go to the welfare office or not, or just wait till after Victoria. Because my ribs are still not 100% yet. So, like, my dentist appointment and the pass thing is all on hold. But on the 22nd is payday, which is only a few weeks away. So, I'm trying to meet up with my dad and then pay rent. And then, if Titanic's still out, I'm gonna go see that with my friend. So, that's if it's still out. And if I'm like doing well, then I'll go. And that's the only time when I buy coffee is when I'm out all day. Because now I feed the cats at 7 a.m. and then I feed them usually around 3 or 4. So that's usually when I'm out. But then on payday, I usually feed them like around 7, and then I'll feed them on whatever time I get back because they always have dry feed out too, so it's not that big of a deal. But yeah. Oh, I know I could have Fabby feed them and stuff, but I'm like, I don't really want to make them come down, come make them feed them and see all the mess. Although it is getting cleaner, it is getting cleaner. So I am really happy now that I found that pack of smokes because I'm like, I really don't want to go out on Wednesday because I've been out every single day this weekend. And I'm pretty sure that's why my ribs hurt. So now I don't have to go out till Thursday or Friday. And hopefully by then somebody will donate some money. If not, I'd still have the $15. So it's like not that big of a deal. And I still have some allergy pills, so I have been taking less. But yeah, my allergies have been so messed up. I've even been doing the sinus rinse because I always sniffle, and that's why. So I do apologize for that because I watch all my videos too, and I'm like, oh, I sniffled again. I'm sniffling again because of my allergies. And so it's like, yeah. So now, I just have to do, as you can see, how messy my oven is, because those are all the cat dishes. Because of the mess that I did. So, and now everything's like on this side. So, I kind of wish I had a bigger kitchen, but sadly, I don't have a lot of drawers and stuff, but I just have to move this out of the way. I wipe this down. That's where I put my cutlery and stuff on that shelf, and then my coffee and all that. I do have drawers up top. It's just that I need the chair to get on top, so I just have the coffee and extra coffee and drinks up there. And then over here is the shelf that I have. So usually I have like the pots and pans and my Instant Pot, but right now I have the spices over there and the table over there. So then that way, once the spice rack was clean, I could wipe down the spices, put them over there, and then clean the shelf. Because I always clean down the shelf from the front, from the back. Like I flip it over and then I do it on the other side. And then I gotta do the top of the fridge because I haven't done that in a while. But I don't think I'll do that tonight. I think I'm just gonna concentrate on this side because it's just, this is where most of the cornstarch went on the floor. And I gotta clear the oven. So I can't do that till I have space, so I don't know if I'll even like put away the spices tonight. I might just move the dishes over to the small table and then wipe it down because, like I said, every night before I go to bed, I always wipe down the oven and I always do the floors. So that's why I'm doing the floors right now. I'm like, I can make the Twix bars, but I gotta clean. But I'm still like wide awake and I feel like I have a lot of energy right now, so we'll see. But I'm gonna at least try to finish doing this side and then maybe do the filming area. But right now I feel like cleaning's actually a lot better than cooking because I'm finding a lot of stuff. And the cleaning, yeah, it just makes me feel good because everything's out of the way. And yeah, it's just, there's been, but we'll see. I mean, I might actually end up falling asleep after days are realized because now it's like 5 o'clock. So, we'll see though, because like my mind's awake, but my body is tired. So, I don't know. We'll see how I am. But I love french fries. So I'm not even gonna eat all of these. I'm gonna put them in the oven. I mean, in the fridge. So yeah, I think I'm just gonna move the dishes that are on the oven and then this bag out in the fridge, the compost bag. So put that down at the bottom of the fridge, move the cat dishes onto that table because it'll be dry soon, and then wipe down the fridge. And then, yeah, I might go to bed because it is like 5 o'clock now. So by the time I eat, it's like 6 or 7-ish. So we'll see. I might not even feed the cats till like later in the afternoon. Just because I might be too tired by the time I lay down. Starting to get tired now because I have been cooking. It's just that stuff hasn't been turning out the way that I want it to. And yeah, all that I have to do is just wipe down the oven. So I already did the floors. Well, this side of the floor. So I'm going to stop this video. So yeah, I'm probably most likely going to call it a night. Even though I'm awake, I'm just going to eat and rest and try not to overdo myself because there's stuff that I want to do tomorrow. So at least all my dishes, even though like I got a pile of dishes there, they're all rinsed. I always rinse them. So that's a big thing. I never used to do that. I used to just leave it there and then soak it. But then, now that I'm older, I'm like, yeah, no. I gotta rinse them. And then whatever I don't get done tomorrow before I go out, I'll just do later because my laundry is more important right now. And like I said, a lot of people on YouTube don't even have intros, so I'm not too worried anymore about it because it will come when it comes. So I'm just focused on cleaning right now and cooking because so much. But I really didn't want to make those Twix bars, but it was more important to clean the floors and the spice rack and counters and get the dishes washed, rinsed. So pretty productive. So yeah, I'm just gonna move these over to the shelf since I'm still talking. So yeah, but stay tuned. I am trying to work out on the filming area as well. It's just like I keep saying, there's only so much I could do. Thankfully, I found the pack of smokes, so now I don't have to go out till Thursday or Friday, so I'll be home more cooking and cleaning and doing all that. So I will be updating you guys when I'm at home. But yeah, sadly I tried to do all this cooking today, it just didn't happen. So I don't know if you guys have an easier recipe how to make like chips, but it was a red lentil cracker chip kind of recipe, and it just did not work out. It just stuck to the parchment paper, and I guess I could have done it without the parchment paper, but then it'll get even messier, and they did it, so yeah. But I'm not gonna bother trying to make my own chips anymore. It's just too complicated. I'd rather make cookies. Cookies are easy to do. So, yeah, wow, almost 30 minutes already that I've been talking. So on that note, I am going to go for a smoke and then wipe down the counter, eat my food, probably watch 2.5 Men by then, because like I said, it is 4:45 now, so it's like 5 a.m., pretty much 5 a.m., so I don't think we'll stay up too long. Yeah, but I just wanted to do that quick update, but at least I got some fries. Some french fries. I love french fries. Holger. And french fries are vegan. Most of the time. So. I've been really into tomatoes again. I've been eating that with my bread because avocado is so expensive. But at least I did half the kitchen. It's just that I have to do underneath the shelf, but it's not that dirty. I just did it the other day. So, yeah, 4:45, I'm actually shocked that I'm still awake. So on that note, I'm just going to warm up my leftovers, my soup, I got my fries, and then wipe down the counter, or wipe down the counter before I eat. And then watch 2.5 Men and go to bed. Because, yeah, pretty tired out now. I let the... If you guys won't watch 2.5 Men because of Ashton Kutcher, one of my favorite episodes is actually the musical where they sing the song, Douchebag. So, if you guys won't watch it, just at least watch that episode, because I still find that hilarious, and I always call people douchebags. I'm like, he's such a douche. He's a douche. And my ex was a douche. Some of you guys I know are douches. So, I think that's pretty funny. The douche. And then I still have a lot of people still call him a douchebag that I used to work with at Rogers Arena. He wasn't really a douchebag, it's just that we didn't even... I had a crush on a guy at Rogers Arena when I was working there, and so he's like, oh, talking to me every single day, and he was like, oh, we could go meet up, and blah, blah, blah. And then later, at that time, I was living in North Vancouver, so I just worked the night shift. And then he's like, oh, let's meet up downtown. So I'm like, okay, fine. Well, since I have to go downtown, I might as well meet up with him. And then I had a family event. So I met up with him after the family event. But then I had to go back to North Vancouver. So I was like, I would have just went home. But he's like, no, let's meet up for coffee, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, I still haven't even slept yet because I had the family thing. And he was like, well, you made such a big deal to, like, find out who I was, so I wanted to meet you. So at least you met me. But then he didn't want to be friends. He didn't want to, like, date. He didn't want to do anything. And he just wanted to meet me because I went out of the way to find out who he was. I was like, could have just told me that beforehand rather than waste my time going all the way down there, because I liked him, but I didn't like him that much. So that's why I call him a douchebag. So, yeah, if you're not interested in somebody, tell them. It's so much better than wasting somebody's time. Or being like, oh, I don't want to hurt their feelings, blah, blah, blah. Like my ex, I kept going on and on about that. It's like, if you just told me that,
long time ago, then it would have been, like, different. But no, he just kept, because he wanted me to be in the corner, basically. And it's just like, ugh. He's a real douche, though, because he never did anything for my birthday, and I kept helping him out. And ended up being a mess because of him. And he still doesn't care. So, and he's like, oh, well, we could still be friends. I'm like, why the hell do I want to be friends with a douchebag? You know, somebody who only cares about themselves and doesn't even bother saying, coming to see Speckles or sending money for Speckles. No, no. So, he's a douchebag. But I'm just like, oh. I know. Everybody's like, you should keep talking about it, but it's how I let go of things. If I just let everything but boiled in, then, and then people, like, learn from me, so, like, I keep saying, I keep telling my friend, you can still be there for someone and help them, but not have to be in a relationship with them, but they want to be with them, so, I've accepted it, and I let them be together, but I'm like, just reminding you, I've been in that same position more than once with different guys. So, yeah, it's just like, that's why, another reason why I like, why I talk about it. So other people learn from my shitty experiences. People just don't change. And some of them do, but some of them don't. And that's where it affects you over, so, yeah. And then I keep doing it, because I'm just like, can't believe that I did all that. Just like the cookie, I'm like, oh, I just wasted so much time cooking and nothing came out. But I did find a pack of smokes, so maybe if I keep cleaning, I might find another pack of smokes, but most likely not, because I did smoke quite a lot. But yeah, so, it's just, but yeah, that's why when people are like, oh, don't keep talking about it, well, it helps not only somebody else, it helps me to get my frustration out. If you don't talk about it, that's when it messes with your head, and then you get depressed, and then stuff like that happens, and people are like, oh, well, you could have a journal. I'm like, what's the point of having a journal if I can't get feedback from people? And I know there's a lot of my friends that are going through the same thing, either with an ex, or they're feeling the same thing, like they wish things were different, but